Well.
Right. Cue music.
G-Funk is back. We taking it back to the days when the horns is the player swing line over bass. We taking it back to the days where we used to kick it's back, like, relax.
You can't just watch that the whole time, man.
Sorry, I got distracted. The days when the
yo, 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 yo.
Oh, man.
No, my hooky, my welcome back to another episode of the Kiwi NRL podcast. Today in the Fit Zone Creative Studio space, we have Jason Weatherly.
Hello.
I didn't say hello to you.
Well, I'm saying hello.
Hello, how are you, mate? You good?
Yeah, no, I'm good, I'm good.
That's bloody good, mate.
Yeah. Good weekend for you?
Really good. Still dealing with my hangover.
Make that two of us. Yeah, make that two of us, man.
And we also through the magic of Zoom, we've got Timo Brookie back on the potty, stepping up, stepping in, filling a gap. How are you?
Good, mate. Happy to be summoned from the bench this week. I've earned another call up from my last performance. So
it was a pretty solid performance.
Pretty desperate. Solid. Pretty solid.
Desperate for numbers.
We are desperate, but you also had a solid performance.
Thanks, mate.
As always, we'd like to thank our sponsor, Fit Zone, bringing a great health and fitness experience to the local communities. Yeah, thanks heaps. Thanks for the beers. I was going to have a drink your beers tomorrow. They're at home that you left behind.
Right, mate. It's that's a donation to the podcast.
Oh, how good.
We'll have them next time. But we're on the Hazy Showboat, courtesy of Max.
Max. Surely they'll be at us soon, eh?
But bought by Fitzone. So, yeah. Moving on.
Oh, I got to bring up the... We do year now. You got any year nows this week?
Yes, I do. Didn't put it out there for anyone to do any prep. Yeah, yeah.
Obviously, I'm feeling.
So, we got a couple. So, the next section is year now. Yeah, 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 nah, nah. Nah. Yeah, 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 nah, 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 nah.
The year nah.
Yeah or nah. All right. So, the first year on up for tonight. Is Stacey Jones, Warriors coach. He's only one game in. But, year or nah. You want to kick us off, Timo? Is it a year or nah from you?
It's a year from me. I've enjoyed seeing some of the content throughout the week. He had, Campion and Clinton Torpy had them in camp. So hopefully they can sort of restore some mana. So, yeah, that's a yep from me, fellas.
Solid year. A little junior. All right, Jace.
I'm a year. Why? Yeah. Why hasn't he had the chance before? Is it because we're coaching there?
I don't think he wants to.
Oh, well.
Like, not.
If he wants to now, like, give him a chance, man. Like,
you know, he's got the opportunity now, not that he asked for it. But
yeah, but if he does good, give him a chance. Plus, like, talking about, like, who they want as coach, but
yeah.
Play up the year and see how he goes.
Surely.
So I'm a year. And I feel like, obviously, the player he was, the boys will, like, have the ultimate respect for him as well.
Yeah.
So it's good when you have that better coach.
Yeah, it's a year from me. He's only had one game, and he couldn't really make any changes because I think it was on the Tuesday. Yeah, Nathan Brown got sacked, and then he got appointed. So didn't make any changes to the team. I wouldn't be surprised if he makes a few changes this week.
Mm.
But yeah, I think attacking wise, it looked like they had a bit more of a license to bloody throw the pill around. So I can almost guarantee that's a Stacey Jones influence there. So it's a year for me. Why wouldn't it be?
Mince horse.
Give him the rest of the year.
Give him the rest of the year.
You can't expect him to start winning straight away, but it's going to be mad when they beat the Panthers next
you've had
this
since
week.
Tuesday to get this team going.
It's going to be mad when when he pulls on the 7 jersey and jumps on for the boys.
Yeah.
They defeat Penrith. Cool. The next year or nah, still Warriors themed. Sean Johnson.
Oh.
You could send him home now for a break and give him a couple of weeks because they've got to buy, obviously, with the international game.
Yes.
give him a couple of weeks with the fam and that back home, and then he can meet up with the boys at Mount Smart, return at Mount Smart for the Tigers after a couple of weeks with the fam. Thoughts?
Yeah. I just feel like he's not in it at the moment. Although, I don't know, he did a couple of different things in the weekend. Like,
yeah,
he actually took a few tackles. And
I think he was trying some different stuff, which is good. But I think he just looks down.
Like down and flat, like.
That's what I mean. Spent a lot of time away from his missus and the baby and that, and the rest of his family, obviously. But I think that could
change things
up. I think you could try that. And then he comes back in Tigers and it's no good. Then it's just like, then you have to obviously have a different conversation.
But I wonder if it's different for them as well. If they like, say if he went home for 2 weeks and he watched their games just like on Sky Sport and be like, fuck man, that's what we need to hit that get. Like, I wonder if he gets a different perspective if he's not in the game where he can watch it.
I guess so. He's still watching it. They watch it all week.
Yeah, they watch it all week. But then he's also
part of it in the team. Yeah, I know what you're saying. Yep. So is it a year from you? Or
yeah.
What do you reckon, Timo?
Yeah, I guess like as an individual, depends how he sort of would take something like that. Eh? Some players would obviously probably take a bit of a confidence knock if they were told to take a couple of weeks off. But I think you guys are right. Like, it sort of looks like he's a little bit flat. I was thinking about it today too. Like when I think of some of the good halves, like Munster and Ben Hunt, for example, they just do like they've got those extra efforts in them in a game. Like it's you know, getting there where they don't have to be there.
Yes.
Or, you know, those sorts of things. Whereas, I mean, yeah, Johnson is as a game manager type player these days. Like, he's not the electric runner and stepper. But, yeah, I just feel like, I don't know if it's energy or just not into it. It's just sort of seen. So I think something like that for him would be good. Like, they do say a lot more game time helps build confidence, but... Yeah, like you said, I feel like there's something.
He just looks flat.
More to it,
You know, when there's an error, he just like hangs his head and stuff. So I'm like,
yeah, and like all it could be is like you say, is like just missing home, missing his family.
Well, it's hard when you're doing it tough and you ain't got your family there. Not that it excuses it's all
his first kid,
Yeah, especially it does not excuse performances, but I think it's worth trying. You might as well throw that young guy into the wolves with Penrith.
Might as well
sink or swim. Yeah. Nah.
Hey man, we'll let you go against Penrith.
Yeah, you're going to debut against Penrith. But that's just an idea I had. I thought that could be quite timely because I can't, you know.
Especially because you've got the buy in there as well.
He's obviously, unless one of those other two, Hughes or Jerome, get injured, he's not on the Kiwis team.
Yeah, well, you'd be surprised if he was.
So that means you can give him a couple of weeks off, you know, get the right head space, get the body refreshed. Mount Smart, return game, boom, he'll be hissing.
Yeah. There'll be a lot of first try scorer bets. I
reckon. Anyway, but that's just me. But if you're listening, Stacey, that's what I do. But of course he listens. Yeah. One more. I've got that. I listened to the YKTR Sports podcast about they done a preview of the Origin, which is just a provincial game of rugby league. But anyway, they spoke about halves combinations and then they bring up Hughes and Brown, how they stack up against Cleary and Luai and DC and Munster. And they all had them as third to them. But, you know, where do you think these two can get to if they get a bit of time together? Like, I personally think that if they can consistently be in the jersey for a long period of time, they're pretty consistent players.
Yeah.
They could come one of the best pairings or that we've half pairings we've had. So that's a year and a. Could they be the best halves, Kiwis halves pairing ever? Because you've got to think about what other halves pairings. Like Foran and Johnson
were good. Not just like halfback, but the pairing itself.
Foran and Johnson were really good for that little period. But I'm thinking like, you know, Dynasty mode.
Stacey Jones and
6 years.
Yeah, who else have been some good halves pairing?
Well,
there's those historic ones, eh?
Yeah, then you have to go right back, which we aren't as old,
Gary,
so I don't really know them.
Gary Freeman, yeah. Didn't get to see that.
They're pretty solid players.
Yeah, definitely.
As a combination, New Zealand hasn't usually had a really strong halves combination for a long period of time. Unlike, you know, Australia or State of Origin teams, they'll have a combo that can last like Cronk and Thurston or Thurston Lockyer kind of vibes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. When you when it hasn't been Foran and Johnson, I feel like it's always been like a six that doesn't normally.
That's right.
Like Harris has played six.
Yeah.
Hick has Peter Hickey played six for the Kiwis.
I'm not sure if he has. I know Bromwich has as well. Oh no, he played hooker.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, he played hooker. But like, yeah, then like Stacey Jones and Nigel Vangan are right? They used to be a
good pairing. But you know, but for how long were they?
And how less like consistent these guys have been at the moment.
Yeah, and I dare say, you know, if we were playing international last year, they would have had a few tests together. But
yeah,
I reckon they could be. You know, if they can get a good solid 5 years of playing for the Kiwis together, I think that's a long time, really, in the for Kiwis for the Kiwis team anyway.
Definitely.
Yeah, all right. I reckon that. Yeah, that would.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely up there.
Yeah.
Top three.
All right. So that brings the end to year or nah. What's our next section usually?
Player of the round, I think.
Player of the round.
Round. And, that goes into our to where did he go and then your team.
All right. All right. Player of the round.
Do you want to start us this time?
I'll start us off. I'm starting to sound like a broken record. Also note, we're recording while the Parramatta game's being played.
Yes.
So what we say on the potty tonight will be said, but then if one of those boys in the Para team or the Bulldogs team outperform someone else, then we can make some changes and I'll post them later. But this is post the Parramatta game. It's just so hard not to go past Joseph Tarpany. I have to give it to him again. Just an absolute weapon, absolute machine.
Like,
is he now in? I guess it depends. James Fisher's Harris is in a real good system, so his numbers probably aren't going to look the same, and he's not going to probably stand out as much.
Yeah.
But is Joseph Tarpany like the new top dog?
Like, I was looking at his stats earlier.
Top gun.
So he had six offloads, which is pretty mad to do.
Yep.
33 tackles for one missed, 4 tackle breaks, 243 running metres, and 68 of those were post-contact metres, 194 hit-ups, and 29 kick return. Like, those are mad stats for the Joker.
Yeah, what a machine. I had to give it to him. I've done it a lot already, but...
Well, just to go with you there, he's my player of the round as well.
Right. Who'd you come up with, Timo?
Look, fellas, I didn't get around to watch too much rugby league in the weekend, but just from what I'd seen, because I've just been watching highlights, so I only get to see the odd touch or two, but I'm going to have to give mine to Timaiti Martin.
Yes, actually, I do. That's a good point, yeah, because he was involved a lot, eh? Mm. Some good involvements.
Yeah, I just saw a lot of their tries, yeah, he was sort of involved.
Two tries, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
He's going well.
At fullback, yeah. I thought it was just going to be a fill-in for 1 week at that posio, but he's really. Well, they were saying that they haven't lost a game since he's been there.
That's right.
That's what I had written down. Yeah.
Yeah.
They haven't lost a game since. So that's pretty mad stat, really.
He does bring a whole new and another dimension to their attack. Yeah. They basically got three halves out there. Nice, bro. Nice. All right. We'll roll straight from that into the Tawaraniko Awards leaderboard awards. Give out 3-2-1 points for Kiwi players from the round that stood out to you. And you might as well go first, Timo, since you already was just speaking.
Yeah, cool. So I got Timaiti as my 3 points. Based on those stats you've read out, I'm going to go 2 points to... Tarpini. And my 1 point, let me just double check my list again. I quite enjoyed, I didn't get to see like the Storm game, so I don't know how the Kiwi boys went in that. But that Broncos forward, what's his name? Is it TC Robati?
Robati, yeah. Oh, yeah, it's a
good I saw he had it. I think he had a connection with Timaiti Martin. Was a nice little offload where Martin ran through, and then I just saw him running some nice lines too in the highlight. So
nice.
He went really well, I think, in the Maldives game earlier this year too. So yeah, he's my my one pointer.
All right. Since Jason's entering that, I'll just say mine. All right, I've gone.
What was his name?
TC Robati.
Robati. Robati. Robati.
Robati.
Robati.
So my three goes to Tarpini, obviously. Brilliant, great game. Can't wait to see him pull the black jersey on again. He's going to be huge for that test, I reckon. My 2 points that goes to Ronaldo Mulitalo. Yeah, he had a really good game. Him and Dell had a good little battle. Unfortunately for Dell, Ronaldo was on the better team. But they had a nice little stoush. I enjoyed watching. Yeah, he was good. A little in and away on Reese just to get that try as well.
Good finisher, eh?
Yeah, was a hat trick? Hat trick, eh? Yep, he got a hat trick.
Two.
Didn't get two. Yep. Oh, was it Katoa that got the hat trick?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sweet. And then for my one, I actually went Brinton the quarter. I think he done a lot of mahi in that game and some good hard running lines. So giving Brinton a point there. I think that's how you say.
Nice.
Man, we've got a few.
Few extras Brinton, this week.
Brinton in.
Yeah. Might be his first points for New Quarter.
Yeah, bro, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 debuters this week.
All right. How good. And then Jace, you're next, obviously, but you're just doing entering in.
So I've gone Tarpini for my three as well. Obviously, this is a solid joker, solid game. For my two this week, I've gone Manly, Josh Eloi, is it?
Eloi, yeah, he played good.
Couple of tries.
Did he get a double?
That is main.
Yeah.
I've seen quite a few of his runs.
I got it on my phone because I... what has he got? Two tries, 90 post-contact meters, 18 tackles, zero miss, so that's always a good stat, and then 224 running meters.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So he's got my two this week, and then my one goes to Mulitalo.
Nice.
Ronaldo, what about that try celebration, though?
Well, the actual Ronaldo. Still. I was actually fuming at it, though, at the time. Because I was watching it as a Warriors supporter, but nah, he played well. And so did Katoa on the other side, actually. So that would bring us into the...
team.
The team. Oh, once you've entered that in, what's our tally? I put them in order of... highest to lowest?
I mean, oh, they are now?
Yeah. Well, ish.
Pretty much be similar, I think, because we've got a lot of debuters.
Yeah. But how much does Tarpini out by
Yeah, so Tarpini's on 32 points now.
He's got points every round from someone,
He's over double the person in second place.
Oh, which is
Fisher Harris on 14, and Manu on 14, and Papalihi on 14. But, like, this could change.
Yeah. Possibly, but I probably won't change mine.
Yeah. And then, yeah, we've got Jay Hughes. He had a right game. He got a couple of tries, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I think he just botched one try.
That was mad, eh?
Swiluck comes across and got him. Sweet. So we're rolling to the team of the week, eh? Kiwi's team of the week.
Yep.
Who wants to start us off?
Okay.
You go, Jace.
Okay. A couple changes this week again. I've gone to Mighty Martin at one again.
Yep, okay, yep.
I've changed my bench up, so I've got him at one.
Yes.
Number two, I've got Ken Mamalo or Bailey Simonson, depending who
plays better.
After tonight's game. My centres are Hiku and Manu, obviously. Mulitalo at number five. And then the halves pairing of Dylan Brown and Jerome Hughes.
Nice.
Number eight, Fisher Harris. And then number nine, I've gone Marshall King. Changed it up a bit. Gone Marshall King. He didn't.
I was actually thinking doing the same thing.
He's last week's game, he had 43 tackles for zero missed.
Yeah.
He was mean. And then it'll be good to see how he goes this week.
Because I've been throwing up using him off the bench, or when I have used him, it's on the bench.
Well, that's what I've done. I've gone Brandon off the bench because he's more versatile player off the bench.
And he hisses a lot more.
Yeah.
I think, you know, Jeremy Marshall King coming on off the bench, you're probably not getting the best value from.
Yeah, so I've gone Marshall King at number 9, Tarpin at 10, pretty ricky at 11. Nakota, he had a solid game, like you said.
Yep.
At number 12, and I've moved Papalihi to 13. And then 14, Brandon Smith, because he's just got that hiss off the bench, and that's why Storm play him there. And then Josh Aloe at number 15, Tuhu at 16, and Jesse at 17.
All right, nice. Nice, man. Thank you. I like it.
Thank you.
There's a couple of plays in there that are almost done. Ooh. So, no, I like it. I like it, man.
Nice.
Who wants to go? Do you want to go next, Timo? You got yours ready?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll go next, fellas.
You go, mate.
So, number one, I've got Timaiti Martin there as well. Number two, I've gone for the Titans winger, Greg Maju.
Maju. Yes, he's a unit.
Sorry, got a solid try for the Titans.
Yeah.
But I can't remember which edge a lot of their tries were let in on. I think I remember seeing Patrick Herbert doing a lot of chasing. So defensively, he might need some work on defense, Maju, but I just think he offers heaps as a ball carrier, especially if we're going. No, you raised a good point a few weeks ago, Len. If you're going to have someone like Timati at the back, having some sizable wingers is key.
Yeah, definitely.
I've chucked in, I don't know if he's pledged to New Zealand, but is Tane Milne, is he?
Yeah,
I think online so. He was born in New Zealand, but he's played for Fiji. But
he has. He can play for Fiji or New Zealand. So he can play for both, but you can chuck him in. I'm okay with that.
Like, we've been chucking four in and he's like retired, so until we know for sure.
Yeah. Same with Tohu as well.
Yeah.
He's just seen a couple of games of Tane Milne where he's got a couple of meat pies and he's just
solid.
Like a good, angry, aggressive
guy.
Centre.
Yep.
Him and Joey Manu, I forgot about because that Cowboys game feels like it was so long ago. I forgot about Pitt, but that's all good. Joey Manu, yeah, the other centre. Molotalo on the other wing. Dylan Brown, Jerome Hughes. As my props, I've gone that Broncos young fella, the TC Rawbati.
Nice.
And just as a bolter. Brandon Smith at 9, James Fisher-Harris 10, Asaya Papali'i, regardless of how he goes tonight, he's just been so hot.
Yeah, so hot.
I've gone Tuhu Harris at 12, in a depleted team, like, so he just still does his job, eh?
Still gets through the mahi.
I think he's still one of the top performers of the game, really.
And then Tarpany at 13. Then on my bench, I've got Jordan Ricky, Britton Nakota, Aaron Clark. And I've put, we're probably light on a prop for that, but I just had Dallin in there too. But
I thought Aaron Clark
can probably do it. Yeah,
Dallin.
Yeah, I just thought Dallin, like, he's still been in a pretty, you know, like, low performing team, but he still manages to get his meat pies, eh? And just makes like little moments.
Even like, how good was that kick at the end?
Yeah, he's got a he's just he's just the energy guy, too.
That's why I found it hard leaving him out of my team.
Yeah, it's hard to leave him out, but. It's just I feel for him a bit being in an underperforming team, like you're saying. Yeah. Really makes it hard for your case if there's a few wingers going around.
Going back to Hicks, though.
Well, that's my team.
I had him for first try scorer on the weekend. I was tossing up between him and Drinkwater. I was like, no, I'll go Hicks. Keep it with Hicks.
Second try.
Drinkwater got first. Hicks got second. I was gutted.
Classic.
Damn it, man.
Damn it. All right, Len's team, the team everyone tunes in to listen to and find out who the great man has gone. the Tony Kemp from Wish. Bring back the Mohawk.
Tony Kempy.
So in fullback I went Timaiti as well, Timaiti Martin at 1, being real solid. Just seeing what he brings to attack on the attack side of things, I think against Tonga, that could be quite good to have someone like that just to kind of shift the ball around. And, you know, they're going to be a massive team. So I think having someone like that will be handy. I've got DWZ slash be Simonson. Simonson's would be unlucky not to get in. He's been playing well. I've gone DWZ.
Leave the door open for him.
Yeah, he's still, at the moment, unless the Parramatta game is like crazy and Bailey just is hectic, then I'll check him in. But at the moment, it's DWZ. And the score update, 16-0 to Canterbury, would suggest he's not doing anything hectic. Yeah. Sweet. And also, my bet's still live from last round. Sorry, Papa Lee, he's still live. I've got no tries, but...
Still live.
Still live, baby. Right, I've gone Joey Manu at 3. Pet Hiku again for the 4. They'll be my mainstays in that centre combo. I've gone for Ronaldo Mulitalo at the other wing. I've gone Dylan Brown, Jaja Bless Hughes, James Fisher Harris, the hooky younger Hoi Ho. And I've gone...
Send it.
I almost done what Jace done and put Jeremy Marshall King there, but I was like, oh... I just cannot. I just need, because I'll go. My bet for that Kiwis game will be Brandon Smith first try scorer again. Because I got last Tonga game as well. I'll go Tarp in there. Plus he'll be trying to snipe. Like that's a good forward pack too. He'll be like sniping. I'll go Tarp in there at 10. Brinton at knee quarter at 11. Isaiah Papali'i Ice Puppy at 12. Jordan Pretty Ricky at 13. I've gone Kay Bromwich at 14. Skillful guy.
Okay, Brom.
He could probably play prop and then go all the way to centre. So he could probably play everywhere from prop to centre. Yes. Be a bit of a stretch for him to play fullback, but he probably would.
He'd take it
good
on.
Coverage. Good coverage.
I got Nasty Nass. He's back from injury.
Yeah, I didn't watch that game.
The big man. I got Jay Brom as well. Isn't it interesting not to have Jay Bromwich starting, but...
It's just the way it is at the
How
moment.
How can I not have those other two? I mean, he is a bit more of a starting prop, so I could possibly look at starting Jesse maybe above Taps, so when he can come on and just like rip and shit and bust.
Yeah, imagine him off the bench, eh?
Yeah, so I could possibly look at, but that's what I've gone for. And then I've gone 17, as Jace alluded to earlier, with Josh Aloai.
Aloai, is that how you say it?
Yep, he played very good. He's been playing well, actually, this whole year. Mm. He's been sniffing around.
He's probably just been just outside our picks every time, but...
It's just hard because you've got
couple
the lights.
Of meat pies in the weekend, like...
The likes of, like, Fisher Harris, Tarpin there. Mm. You've got Jesse Bromwich. You've still got Jared Wadia Hargreaves. It's still, like, every now and then, like, putting up his hand, so... It's going to be hard for him to get, like, you know, but like you're saying, sniffing around. Anyone goes down, I think he slots straight in. Yeah, so it's my team, guys.
Mint.
All right, what's next on the cards? Do we go straight into the best bet?
No, game of the round. So we do game of the round, what we thought was game around this round, or what we had chosen and how we went up pretty much, and then next game around.
Can't even remember what I went.
I went Broncos Raiders, and that was a good game.
That was a good game.
That was a hectic game to watch.
I'd say that probably would be my game.
Yeah, that was my game of the round. That was like try for try, and then.
Yeah. Oh, man. The Cowboys were pretty. I'm going to go Broncos. Yeah, I'll go the same game too. That was a good game. Bloody good game. So you didn't watch many games, Timo, so which one was the best one for you?
What highlights was the best for you?
Well, the only full game I watched was the Warriors one, so that's definitely not my game of the round. who did the Cowboys play again?
I can bring it up here. The Cowboys played
Titans.
Dr. Dragons.
Titans, wasn't it? Oh, that was the round before, sorry, yeah. I was a dragon, so I was about to say that.
I'm just gonna have to go up to the game. You guys mentioned too, like the try highlights and that.
Yeah,
really good.
It was a really good game.
The Bronx.
I didn't watch much either, but I was just going off the game I watched.
Yeah. What are you guys looking forward to this weekend?
I'm looking forward to Storm Broncos.
Same. That's what I was going to pick as well.
Storm Broncos. Yeah.
Just be interesting to see where the Broncos are at. You know?
Even that or Cowboys Manly, because Manly have been playing pretty solid.
Yeah, Manly have been playing pretty good.
Even without their key players. So.
But I still have to go the Broncos Storm game. It's always good when you can get a team.
Heels and Roosters will be a good matchup too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Roosters are kind of there or thereabouts.
And Warriors Panthers.
Yeah, that'll be a whitewash. Warriors. 13 plus.
You hit it here first.
It'd be a blackout.
Keep
your Kiwi Saver on it.
Kiwi Saver on it. And the rest.
And the rest.
All right, so we'll roll into best bets of the round. Haven't managed to get one over the line this week.
Well, I don't know, man.
It's probably half time now in the para game.
Not quite.
Yeah, the para still haven't
scored. Live.
Ice puppy, man. Get some. Come on, brother.
So, who wants to go first?
I'll go first. I've got the bet of the round. Oh, shit. There's no buys this time, eh?
No.
Put out a person who's not playing. Oh, yeah. And this is obviously why. Raiders Knights. I've gone J Tap Taps.
Man, that was my second choice.
He's going to crash over the... what would you say? The flaccid Knights defense.
They do. And I must say,
he'll just have a tough carry close to the post.
Pong is out, eh?
Just bust through.
Pong is out. He wouldn't have stopped
him. I know, he wouldn't have stopped him anyway, but... Oh, nice. So for a
try. Old club too.
For a try.
Nice.
Taps will just look him in the face and be like... And then they'll just fall over.
It's his old club too.
Yep.
Yeah. Considering how the Bulldogs are going at the moment, they're looking good. My bet is Marshall King, a try.
Next week.
Yeah.
This week.
Well, no, hopefully, because he probably won't get one next week then. Next week, because I've listened to the Tigers.
Yes.
So I'm going to go Marshall King, a try, anytime.
Anytime, Kumara, Marshall
King. And he's due one. I'll bring the stats up.
He is due, mate. He's due.
He spaces them out very nicely.
Nicely or spaces him out because he doesn't get many?
No, he's just like, maybe a meat pie this week.
Not spoiled, good choice.
He's on that diet of meat pies. He only has them every now and then.
I actually had one today.
Actual meat pie? A Big Ben?
Yeah.
Standard one or the...
Some cheese, yeah.
Yeah, so you got...
Just the standard one, man.
Standard.
Sloppy Mondays.
Big weekend.
It was
last one was against the Tigers.
Oh, here you go. So there's a theme. There's like a storyline there. Fill your boots, he reckons. What's your bet again?
Marshall King.
Oh, Marshall King. Anytime.
Anytime.
Okay.
Anytime, Kumara.
And
Kumara.
Timo.
It's your best bet, mate.
Look, guys, I'm
it's one for one.
Go for Greg Mazu. First half try scorer.
Oh, so a try in the first half.
Yeah.
Is there an option just for that?
I was going to say, is there an option for that? That'd be mean.
Well, we'll soon find out.
If it's not,
it's just any time.
Yeah.
If it's not, he'll be going over. Tell you what. The Sharks, Titan Sharks. And I've got a gut feeling. Yeah. And
Well, we have the Oracle
the
back.
Tank
so.
In the corner.
He is the Oracle. The pressure's on. He's one from one. He hasn't got one wrong yet. good on you, mate. That's bloody good. All right.
Tips from T, baby.
Tips from T, mate.
You should have. Or what's your thoughts about on? Oh,
there you go.
You go, bro.
No, what's your thoughts about?
So, you could almost. Oh, you could call that segment like the Kiwi Gainer, eh? You know, there's the Kiwi Saver. This is the Kiwi Gainer where you're gaining those funds.
Oh, Kiwi Saver might want to sponsor this. Section of it.
Yes, because I'd love this.
Yeah. Kiwi Saver, Kiwi Gainer.
And put it towards and a half deposit.
The Kiwi Saver Capital Gainer. He's just lost the ball there.
Oh, lucky.
He gets away with it. Oh!
Where's your boy at?
Where is Ice?
Oh,
run the line.
Oh, he was...
Run the line.
Nice.
Dylan Brown just coughs up the pill.
Hey.
All right, all right, so that was best bet of the round, sponsored by KiwiSaver.
Could be a
Kiwi Gainer, sponsored by KiwiSaver.
Could be a good multi though.
Hey, you can multi it up. You could do all sorts of things.
You could
with
be
it.
Like stuff your Jace.
You could tuck it behind your door for like a doorstop. Maybe not. But hey,
who knows?
All right, so that's our last section. We're at the last section, aren't we? The old Kiwi moment.
Yes.
cannot minimise. Okay, that's great. If I went a bit smaller, yes. And if I went like this,
psych.
So this week's moment is
brought to you by JJ.
Brought to you by JJ Moore. Now this is brought to you by Maya Media. Proudly sponsored. We're going with the Dean Fuddy flick back in to RTS, Roger Tuivasa-Sheff, who was actually against England. He's actually made the squad, or the wider squad for your ABs. So congrats, Rog.
Yeah.
Well done, congrats, mate.
Roger.
It was a gimme. You're always going to do it. It's got the work rate of the man.
How good is it? He's gone from the Warriors into a Super Rugby final, like.
With the Blues of all people.
Yeah. Get up the Blues.
So we're going to push play here. Is that Sonny Bill? Talking about cross code, you know, Sonny Bill's just about to play the ball. And Isaac Luke's about to pass it. So let's go.
Isaac Luke. Fallen with a kick on the last. Charlie gets up there. Ooh. Does he? No, he doesn't. It's a New Zealand hand that knocks it back. It's kept alive here. Desperately by the Kiwis. They might make something happen. Isaac Luke again. What throws it over the top.
How mad is that pass? Player, is
what a ball.
What a ball.
Will score one of the great tries.
Just watching it in slow motion too.
Pass out. Now we need something tight on the touchline here.
And then
mad.
Oh.
Been, like,
it's those people that
got some strong obliques.
Yeah, here it is. What's that?
Has possession.
Flick it. Flick it, bro.
The right foot is in the air.
It's culture in motion.
He has released the ball. Let's play on. Okay, now we need to look at the grounding now.
Unbelievable.
Straight to him.
Okay, just a little mini goosey. Just a little mini goosey.
Oh, okay,
try time. Oh, wow, that's loud now. I've got because I'm not signed into the right YouTube. I was like, what? I don't get ads on my YouTube.
No, you do.
What a moment!
That premium now.
Yeah,
World Cup moment.
Yeah, another World Cup moment against England. Pretty good team, but we didn't go that well. And it's the same one we've shown. Johnson, I think.
Johnson.
To get us into the final, but
it sort of flopped there. Flopped in the final, was it?
Yeah, and there was also a bit of a scandal about energy drinks and painkillers.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, do you remember that? They were over there and there was some sort of thing.
Oh, was that during then?
Yeah. But like during J.W. Winch and like Sonny Bill and that.
True.
Hey, man. Like
Tohu Harris, I think, was involved in it too, I think.
No, he didn't go.
Oh, no, that's right. He didn't go because Sonny Bill changed his mind.
Last minute.
Yeah, shit.
What did he get you through in?
That's the old, like, sorry, the coach is like, you know, we're not just going to pick the best players. We're going to pick who turns up to training, guys. And I don't care if Wudumu turns up on Saturday with his boots. He's not playing.
And then Wudumu turns up and Lennie gets dropped.
Well, yeah, that's my childhood. That's my childhood in a nutshell. How much pain, man? No, all good, what it means.
No, all good, bringing it up.
Yeah.
Happens to play your position.
That's also the World Cup that Sonny Bill slipped over in the end goal, eh?
They were talking about that.
Yeah.
In the game?
Oh, yeah, in the Warriors game.
In the Warriors game last night. Yeah, because he got so close to the...
He took it right up and he was like, kind of celebrating semi-ish and then slipped over.
Yeah.
That was against Samoa.
Samoa.
And we're getting ever so closer to the Tonga test, so can't wait till they name the team. And when they do the naming of the team, it'd be good to get like some sort of live reaction. So,
Do we know when they're naming it?
No, I did message them on Facebook, New Zealand Rugby League. I commented on all their posts whenever they post something. When are you naming the team? Battery's low on the computer. That's okay because we're pretty much done. Thanks everyone for tuning in to another episode of the Kiwi NRL podcast, brought to you by the good jokers at Fitzone. Matamata te aroha, pāra and waihi. If you're in those areas, get down to your Fitzone. Sign up to a membership. Say Jason Smiley Weatherly sent you.
Yeah, and you'll get a...
hiding.
You get a hiding.
Oh, I mean, sorry. You'll get and the best deal.
And if you need any videography
yes.
done...
The other sponsor of tonight's episode, My Media. Where can they find you, Timo?
Hey, you can find us on Instagram or Facebook. Just search My Media. We might not be the top one that comes up, but just have a look. You'll find us. Yeah, any video, photos, any of that sort of stuff, man. Yeah, come looking.
All right.
Come get some.
Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. And we'll see you next week, the Kiwi NRL podcast. Go to the Warriors. Oh, no, not Warriors podcast.
I mean, go to the Kiwis.
But come on, Warriors.
Go to the Kiwis.
Come on, Warriors.
Can't wait to sink those line reds. Those line reds in a couple of weeks, fellas.
Yeah, okay. You might see us at the game. That, yeah. Everyone out there, the hundreds that listen.
Oh,
if you see us, if you see us at the game, yeah, come say hello.
Yeah, we'll actually be on the field at halftime, won't we?
Yeah.
Just giving our thoughts and opinions.
Well, I'll be in the coach's box with Madge. The good thing about Madge now is he's got lots of time on his hands. So.
Yeah. Man, how mad is that? Two coaches in 1 week, in like 24 hours, actually.
Both bald as well.
Maybe it's a... Don't shave your head.
There's been a few Trent Barrett too. Not bald, but...
And though
might be somewhere else.
He's the type of man who would be bald down there.
Those three, those three coaches that have gone, and the bottom like four teams, four teams of the table at the moment.
You imagine if like the Storm just said, "Oh, Craig,
hey man, you've been around too long, bro.
You're done, mate."
Yeah.
Or even to Ivan,
you've expired. What Kiwi coaches is there? Trying to wrap it up, eh? But what Kiwi coaches
doing? Skidwell's over in Argentina doing rugby now.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, so but he still wants to keep the Maldi.
The Arge is the wee. Something like that.
We put the R
and G in
Argentina.
R into G. The
Argy and Bargy. Argy Bargy. Don't know. Steve Kearney is still like an assistant at Storm, isn't he?
Yeah.
Who else is there? There's not much. Stacey Jones.
Yeah.
We're rip thin on the ground with coaches.
Bring in Wayne Bennett.
No, he's going to work with. He's helping Tonga, right? This World Cup.
Pirinity.
Which will be great for them.
Yeah.
Great for us, no. All right. Anyway, this is us wrapping it up big time. Right. The outro. Thanks for coming on, Timo. Appreciate it, mate. Good insight as always.
All right, fellas. Till next time.
All right. We'll catch you later.
Later, bro.
Later, bro.
And then.
Recording.
And then, are we pretty much finished?
Yeah, and then I'm just going to play the song out.
Nice.
Just to finish. flat battery. So we see you later.
Man, we're lucky we got Timo hung up in time.
Yeah. All right, peace. West Coast.
Peace.